Thank you for joining XROM, which is India's first AR/VR MR podcast. And today I'm really happy and delighted to have Mr. Rishi Ahuja and Aditya Tipnayak. So Rishi Ahuja is the founder and Aditya Tipnayak is the co-founder of Flip VR, education-based VR company. So rather than me kind of giving the introduction, I will let you on to the mic and you guys can give a brief introduction on what you're doing in the background.
So thank you so much, Eddie. Well, the first thing is that Flip VR is primarily a company which is focused in terms of creating experiences into the education ecosystem, which basically empowers imagination and creativity between the child. So we believe that virtual reality is a great technology. And in India, Flip VR is primarily pushing the boundaries of creating content which is world class and also towards the best of the technologies available.
Right. So Aditya, would you kind of want to add on to that?
Yes, I'm always fascinated with games and animation. I've been doing working with gaming industry for the last 20 years, and I think we are the future now. And being a co-founder for Flip VR, mine and Rishi aim is to dedicate our Flip VR to educating kids through virtual reality.
Lovely, thank you. So Aditya has kind of given me a brief on why virtual reality, but Rishi, you didn't tell me why virtual reality. Obviously, you've been a serial entrepreneur. This is not your first venture. You've also founded Synovatech. So why virtual reality? You've been pretty much okay with the tech space. What was the reason that got you excited about virtual reality?
Okay, one of the key things into virtual reality is that you actually bypass a lot of boundaries of the physical world and get into an environment which is hard to imagine or hard to be present with. Now, when we talk about virtual reality, we started working in virtual reality quite a long time back. And we were looking at creating or bringing this entire virtual reality ecosystem as a powerful tool within our country itself. And when we looked at virtual reality, of course, there's no doubt that in education, it has got a very, very important role of bringing in. But ultimately, virtual reality basically fascinates, you know, be it kids, be it adults, be it anybody. And today, if we look at the overall potential of virtual reality, and if we get the right content onto it, this can actually change worlds. So from my perspective, virtual reality is the next big game changer, which is yet to be explored to the fullest of its potential. And that's what fascinates me.
Right. Yeah, I think I double that, you know, because at this point, we're just scratching the surface of what this technology would be able to do in another few years when it actually starts maturing, you know. So, but there is a problem at this point in time, you know, because I think most of the big companies, you know, are already building hardware, you know, like Apple's getting into the bandwagon. There's already Facebook, Microsoft, Samsung, everybody's building. Jio is getting into the bandwagon, but somehow there is a problem with content. Not many people are kind of like, so there is a huge opportunity over there. You also mentioned that virtual reality as a tool, it's got everything built in for, you know, remote education, remote healthcare, remote training, and so on and so forth. You know, so I am excited for that space because somehow I feel that we've been thrusted into that world because of the pandemic. You know, the pandemic obviously it's got its cons. It's completely disrupted the world. But then suddenly technology has got a huge lens, and especially AR, VR, MR, because it's got all things capable to address the remote healthcare, remote education, or, you know, and remote training and things like that. So I would like both your views. How do you think pandemic has impacted education industry, and what role do you see AR, VR, MR playing in the future of education?
So what I see is that pandemic, you know, has brought in an impact on everybody's life in two different ways. Okay, whereas the pandemic basically resulted in boosting the edtech technology, the remote learning, schools started adopting into technology what they were not looking at all. So definitely it has increased its footprint within our lives in terms of using the technology and how we can still try to, I would say a better word would be to cope up with the current condition. Technology has got a very big boost in terms of making education available remotely to our students. The pandemic, on the flip side, has also given a very, very big impact in terms of the overall, I would say, the mental health and the social connect between the students, which is another very big important thing, that kids are now spending a lot of time in front of their computer screens and ultimately, you know, losing out on the overall development if you look at it. When we talk about AR, VR technologies, I would say that these technologies in the future has a very, very big potential in terms of creating the space of connectivity between the people itself, being closer to each other, if not physically, virtually, and talking to the future that is yet to come. Where we see is AR, VR, and MR playing a very, very important role is bridging the gap between the physical boundaries and bringing people to collaborate on a virtual platform. That is what I see as a major role that VR and AR is going to play over the next period of years.
You know, we have seen nothing of the sort in our recent times, you know, and the education industry has completely been disrupted to a point where students who are graduating don't really know what to do. You know, they have been pushed into a world where automation, the social distancing is driving automation. The kids have less jobs to kind of look at. They have to jump into the world where suddenly your traditional education system is no longer relevant, because there are people like Elon Musk and other entrepreneurs who are also saying that they are not really looking at certificates. They are looking at what skill a person brings onto board. And social connect, obviously, that is something which is so important, relevant. Maybe someday when the technology kind of completely matures, we will be building those virtual worlds which could kind of create that, you know, that physical disconnect that we are feeling at, right now, you know, because of pandemic. Aditya, you've been fronting the gaming industry and so what are your views on
this? There are people who were working for virtual reality for many, many years ago because they know this technology will take over all the manual labors and automation will come and AI will play the major role. So we are seeing or even reading news about machinery, you know, taking over farms. You don't need farmers doing deploying. It's all the tractor controlled by AR doing all the programming, and excavators excavating earth without anybody driving it. So technology is taking over. And Elon Musk, as you mentioned, he is thinking 50 years. Now he's thinking, what is the world after 50? Yeah, so we have to upgrade ourselves. Though pandemic is the disaster what happened in the world, but it pushed the tech 10 years. It accelerated bringing in tech 10 years in earlier days. So we believe that VR is the new technology, and we have to make people come up with innovative ideas which change the world we live in, who solve problem not in 10 years, maybe in 2 years, how you can solve problem instantly, or how you can bring in quick solutions to it. So we need to prepare people, bring in technology, bringing in ideas on the table, solving the issue of the current generation facing and the future which is coming up in front of us. So VR is VR, AR, MR, XR is the only technology what we see, or many engineers are looking at it, is the only solution where we can solve the problem of masses in a very sophisticated way.
We humans are averse to change. You know, like to talk about fancy things, you know, but when you're talking about actual implementation, that's very, very slow. And yes, there are the conversation that we need to have, that where because of social distancing, there will be automation which will, you know, rise, and then because of automation, there will be people who will be losing job. But then there will be millions of other jobs which will be created. Stay relevant in that world, you would need to rescale, upscale, and become lifelong learners. I think that's
the thinking process is changed totally. You know, we are not thinking like our fathers or the way we used to think. And I'm sure the coming generation, my kids or your kids, won't think the way we are thinking right now.
Right.
They will be much more advanced. They will bring in much more new ideas according to the current time.
Right.
You know? So right now, a lot of industry has been opened up because of the internet is spreading. We are connecting. We can connect to anybody in the world sitting anywhere just because of internet. So this generates the new platform. Like now we have OTT in every house. People are generating more, much more media content for entertainment, social, education, science, bringing it all together and just in front of your TV. So anybody who wants to learn is not dependent upon any teacher, or he don't physically doesn't need to go to anywhere. Everything is available. So what a VR is connect is like now you can immersively go into any situation, any kind of issue, you can resolve it physically, means with your controllers or with the haptic suits, you can learn anything, you know. So you want to be a pilot, you can go into a virtual cockpit and be a pilot. You want to be a diver, you can virtually learn anything. So this is will generate new opportunity for educators to create content which teach people, which is very difficult or make, I said, very expensive to learn in a physical form. Maybe you have to go to some place to be a diver or to be something engineer to learn physically, which requires a dangerous, or you can say very, you can get injured while learning it, but in virtual reality, you have gone beyond this issues.
Right. I think you have brought out something really, really interesting, because, you know, I guess there is always that certain section of people who ask questions when there's a new technology. They ask why. And the answer is you just gave them, you know, because this is the technology that enables you to go beyond, you know, where you're training. You gave an example of hazardous training, you know, you can. Yeah. Escape that where there is no risk of life, plus you cut down the price of what you would have actually spent in physical training. So yes, we're getting into a fantastic world, you know, but somehow post the pandemic, I thought that virtual reality would be adopted in a big way, but even now we're still restricted to a 2D platform. You know, though we're talking about, you know, entering the spatial world, you know, where you start interacting with objects exactly like you interact with, you know, in a physical life, but we're still stuck onto the 2D world. And that's the reason I do what I do, because I think there has to be a larger awareness and education of what this technology can bring on both to education and how it can create disruption in the education industry. You guys have been, ClipVR has been fronting the education industry by building content. What has been the challenges and what has been the opportunities that you have seen from inception till now?
Well, before we get into the challenges, you know, one of the most important thing is to address some of the very known factors what this entire technology or what our initiative is based on. Now, if we look at it as a traditional approach, the way our education system had been sitting till now was mostly traditional and cultural, which never got an update from a long time. It actually pushed us into things like, we get into the kind of a rote learning system, because everything was basically based on marks. And I remember, you know, some great words from a great visionary and our ex-president, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. I don't remember the whole sentence, but in one of the forums, he said that knowledge is the key, not the learning is the key. When you have the knowledge, you have a passion to imagine, and you have got passion to make sure that you are basically achieving your dreams and goals coming together. Now, somehow down the line, you know, India is producing visionaries, but you can count them on fingers. The whole objective about creating a technology that does not only help you in being, you know, that does not only teaches you how to imagine or how to make visions, is the first challenge that we have to brought in. So the first thing that we look at it is that we are contradicting the traditional art of teaching and learning and understanding, you know. So that is one particular challenge that we basically face from the world. The second challenge, what that is majorly there, when we talk in context of India and in context of the developing world or the developed world, virtual reality is still an expensive technology. This is not available to masses. This is not available to every household. So that is something which also creates a big challenge. And moreover, at the same time, even if we look at virtual reality, that is always taken as a gaming product rather than more of being an educational product and how that comes. And this is primarily because of the lack of content. Okay, the content that is not just any other content, but a great content. In virtual reality, both me and Addy, we talk a lot of time that in VR, either there is a good content or there is no content. You know, that is what our boundary line, you know, when we talk about. So these are the few challenges. The second side of the challenge is that when you want to create this quality VR content that goes around to people, where people, you know, when they look at it, they say, this is unbelievable. This is unforgettable. These are the words that, you know, we need to get into VR. Otherwise, the VR will never solve the purpose. So creating such content is a time-consuming job, and it's a very capital-intensive job that goes around with that, which we definitely face because we have to make a balance and so on and so forth. So if I have to talk about Clip VR, is primarily working towards these particular challenges, all of them at the same time, and creating an ecosystem where virtual reality becomes one of the key components, if not educating directly to a person. We don't want to teach people in VR what is the algorithm or some square root things. We wanted to create interest in mathematics. We wanted to tell people what is so amazing in this world that they should look at. Okay, how can you be somebody when you have not visioned that? So key aspect of the challenge right now is not just the tech or the pricing or for anything. It's the adaptability of this new technology where people start accepting it, that this is equally important as their traditional system. And last but not the least as a challenge is to balance between what is present today, because you cannot just make it redundant and bring a new technology in altogether. You actually need to make a balance which it says, yes, you know, both the things can work together, because both the technologies have got their positives and negatives, and we need to have a fusion of all of this positives coming together to create it as a great tech which is adaptable.
Aditya, would you like to add more there?
I would say, like, we want to complement the Indian education system right now with virtual reality. We want kids to imagine more, explore more, and dream without any boundary. We want to, our Indian society, what I would say, this fear of failure, you know, which is predominantly injected to us, that don't fail, bring good marks, do whatever, because we are so focused about the marks and we do not focus more on the individual personality or what the child brings in. So as far as my example, if I say, like, I saw my first cartoon film, I think when I was just 9 years old. And since then, I knew what I want to do. I want to get into animations, and that's what I followed my path. I got so much of pressure from my family and relatives to do this, do that. But that was one thing which still attached to me. You know, it's that spark which kids have, which they never got a chance to explore. So we want to bring that spark, and we want to explore the imagination into a child's brain. He needs to see the world, experience as many experiences about different topics, subjects, whether it is going to the moon or doing scuba diving, learning about the history, geography, science, whatever it is. He will get a chance to at least explore it. Once he explores it, he might get some spark where he wants to choose a path. This interests me and I want to follow it further. Maybe I want to make a career out of it. Or maybe I just want to, at my own knowledge, I want to explore it more. So as a Clip PR, our focus is to ignite the imagination in a child's brain, whether it's creatively with the knowledge or with the help of virtual reality, so that he explore more, dream more, learn more, and enjoy life and be a better person.
Right. How cool. Both of you guys got some really, really interesting points. Rishi mentioned about the rote learning system, education system, which is being sucking the life out of students, you know, because there are these bunch of students which is in a classroom and all of them are focused on the blackboard, and there's a teacher who reads out the book, and basically maybe even if he or she goes around, but it's all limited to the books, you know. But even if you take a minute and look around, you know, you see so much which is happening, you know. So we miss out on so much, like life. I mean, the only way it teaches you is by experience.
Yes.
And this tool, the technology that we have, virtual reality, is an experiential tool. You know, with virtual reality, you can experience learning. So it's only if you kind of breach it to those, you know, those traditional driven minds who are still hung up on the thousands of years old.
It's changing.
Yeah, it's changing.
But we cannot afford the slow pace.
Exactly. We cannot afford the slow pace because I think the pandemic has pushed us into a world where, you know, it's become to each his own. You know, there is no government who's going to come and save you. There is no corporation who's going to come and save you. It is you. And I think only and only if we seed our kids into believing that they can do anything that they desire, I think we will have great leaders coming out of India. Not just great leaders, but also great companies. And I don't think they will start running out of a country, but they will build companies over here. So those Googles and those Microsoft will come out of India rather than, you know. So I'm excited for the space. Aditya, I think you may put some really interesting points. With virtual reality, you said it'll let your imagination will open up. You can explore and you can dream without boundaries. I think that's extremely profound. And the fear of failure, I think that is what has been stopping us. But I guess we should let our kids go into the world where it's brave, because and make them understand that everything is possible. Because if human ingenuity and innovation will create a future which is of abundance, rather than this narrative of scarcity, which we kind of have been peddling for the longest time. So you guys have been building some fantastic content. The last content that you built was the Chandrayaan VR expedition. So that sounds really, really cool. Now, is this content available? Are you talking to schools? What's the go-to market plan? Are you talking to education institutes? Are you talking to the government? What's the roadmap ahead?
So when we talk about Chandrayaan, yes, it is already into the market right now. This has already been experienced by a number of children across different geographies in India. The way this entire thing goes about it, this is not just limited content, which we say that it has got boundaries to educational institutions or children. This content has got very, very large focus areas. There are a couple of things within this particular experience. You know, when we started looking at into the content, you know, one of the most important thing of Clip VR is that we wanted to make content which is for the Indian market, but with a very, very high global perspective onto the top of that. Now, Chandrayaan VR experience is primarily all about being present at that particular moment, at that particular event, witness it, role play it like a scientist like an engineer and feel proud about it, of how this entire journey actually takes place. So this is a very, very integrated content that we created. It not only just makes you feel like, you know, you are a scientist or an engineer, but it also allows you to actually be present on the moon and create and conduct your own experiments within that particular duration of the Chandrayaan, as a Pragyan would have done over there. So the whole content was unique. So we have a very, very wide audience. We have been welcomed by everybody, actually. So all institutions, academics, non-academic groups, we are basically spreading this out to as many as number of kids which is there. So Chandrayaan is just the start of the title, is just part of the entire area of what we are going to offer. And in fact, the experience of Chandrayaan is to make sure that people remember this. They don't forget what India has done. It's all about creating that sense of interest that actually pushes you to the next level and the next boundaries. Explore those areas where you could never even go. I mean, today, if you look at our generation, we are looking at creating visionaries. And that's the overall objective that Chandrayaan basically delivers when it comes on to be. The way we do it is very, very unique. This is ClipVR as a whole system, I would say, that holds the content, okay, which is presently over there. And the way this has been devised and it has been made is that we take VR to masses. These are not just individualistic experiences. I mean, ClipVR can deliver this Chandrayaan as an experience to 100 people at the same time, at the same location, with yet having their own individual experiences and role playing within that entire system. So this is how Chandrayaan primarily works onto it. And of course, our next titles are already lined up, which are coming shortly. But yes, this is being very well acknowledged everywhere altogether.
I see the passion from your end when you talk about technology, and you stressed on building content which is not just Indian but also global. I think that is the need of the day, because I mentioned that, you know, some of the biggest companies are building HMDs, you know, Facebook, Google, everyone, even Jio is building, and they are, Jio and Facebook are working on democratizing it in a way where they're trying to get the price points down. But there is not many people who are building content, and the ones who are building content are not being brave and bold enough, because I do understand that it comes with these limitations, because it's expensive to build content at this point in time. You know, maybe in the next maybe this decade, it might get cheaper, you know. But right now, yes, it is a little expensive. You said that you have been talking to schools and stuff like that. What is the monetization plan? What if somebody wants to view this content, how do you go about it? If a school wants to accept this in a curriculum, how do they go about it? Because this is extremely fascinating. It's more of like completely disrupting education. Because I remember when I was a kid, I had very limited tools. I was never given the opportunity to, you know, experience a moon landing. But I guess today, education is giving you that experience to go experience a solar system. Yeah. You know, not just see it in a book, but actually experience it around, yeah, you know, experience the moon and stuff like that. So it's extremely profound. I hope and I wish through this messaging tool that we have created, that education institutes and organizations understand the how profound this is and how deeply it will impact the education industry. Again, I'll come back to the same question. What is the pricing point, A, and what has been the challenges of AR/VR? You mentioned about the price point and stuff like that, but is the education awareness of this technology also a problem?
I would like to answer these questions in a very simplistic manner. The pricing is as simple as that. This is much lesser than the cost of a pizza that you eat outside there. So this becomes very, very affordable for everybody to look for this particular entire experience that it goes. The second part is that, of course, although our very big market is masses and they come from diverse different areas, you know, so we are not only just limited towards institutions, but we are also limited with residential groups, you know, which are their community groups where it goes all together. So there's a whole ecosystem that works behind the overall pricing. And the pricing is primarily based on the number of experiences and masses, the more they capture to. This is not about creating, you know, something that is a one-time sale kind of a thing. We don't look at that particular thing. The way it goes is that the uniqueness of the entire model, okay, which goes about it, it does not hurt anybody. This is a self-sustainable business model that works on the principles of the more you let experiences happen, the more it thrives altogether. So that is one part of it. The second thing is that when we talk about the business models, I completely believe that it is completely related to content. If you create a content which has a shelf life, then definitely you are into a trouble because everything is based on fashions. Okay, everything is based on trends. Okay, if you look at our parallel industries, with gaming or anything, you know, the new tech is always coming. So the question that, and the quest that we basically resolved, how can we make this content go, be still equally fascinating, you know, even after 5 years, 6 years. So our content that we produce has got no boundaries to it in terms of time. Every day, you know, we get more and more, you know, people, you know, viewing our content. Okay, it's still fascinating. Okay. And there is no age restriction to this content. So VR is all about that everybody has a unique experience in terms of learning. So be it a kid or be it an adult or a teacher or a parent or a grandfather, they all love this kind of a content because knowledge is something that everybody wants, you know. So and there is no restriction for gaining knowledge. So I would like to keep this certain things as unique USPs under the covers, okay, as of now. But yes, you know, I'll be more than happy to disclose the way we are doing things, you know, maybe in my next podcast with you.
Perfect. Aditya, is this content available only in English or is it in different languages? And is this a mobile VR experience or it's viewed on...
Right now, we are creating all our content in English.
Right.
It's widely accepted and we can go to any region in India and we can showcase it. So there's not a region-specific language. So that's why we choose English to be predominantly all our content to medium. Secondly, this is like a service. You can call us. We can come to your school, do our setup, give experience to each and every children in the school, and then we move out. So it's very easy for school. They don't need to do any specific or any special arrangement in their school. They don't need to buy anything. We just walk in and walk out. That's why we keep it very open. It's like a VR lab. So we go and we come out.
And this is only available in Delhi or all over India?
We are starting with Delhi NCR right now. But our vision is to expand to Pan India soon, very soon.
Right. Are you guys bootstrapped or funded?
We are bootstrapped.
Probably. Right. Is there a plan to go ahead and look at funding? Because there is so many conversations I've had with people who are funding this industry, and there's one thing I think people have missed out is that opportunity there in the content industry. Because like I said, I'm saying it again, but I'd like to repeat it because there is so many headsets which are coming in the market, but there is lack of content. And I hope that the VCs and the angel investors understand the opportunity which is over there, because it's inevitable that in another few years or maybe under this decade, a computer and a mobile will converge into one single wearable device, which will be at a price point which will be consumer friendly. And once that happens, the most important thing at that point in time will be content. And I think content. I hope the people who are listening in understand the opportunity, because I think the content is going to play a huge role.
See, the content is not the issue, it's the technology.
Right.
You know, people do not adapt technology, they will be out of the games. Like you take past example, like a Kathputli show or any other show, they couldn't adapt to the changing technology. And people are not interested anymore to watch a Kathputli show. Just to give you an example. So wherever there's a technology progressing, a content or the way of producing it needs to adapt to the changing technology. Like the movie production, if you say everything is virtual now, so you don't need physical sets. Actors start acting in front of the green screen, so you don't need physical sets. Now even you don't need a green screen. You just perform and you have a virtual set around you. So adapted, the technology is changing very rapidly. It's not 5 years, it's like every year or maybe 6 months, something new is coming up, something better than the current technology. And we are very much confident that we're going to adapt to the current technology. We are bringing the best of the technology or the hardware. If right now we are using Oculus, if Jio comes with a better headset, we'll move to Jio. We are content producer and we'll adapt whatever the best technology or with the competitive pricing. We moved on to that. So we keep on progressing.
Right. And I hope that the education industry, I mean, listening to this, make a move. Yes, we are averse to change. But like you said, you know, if you don't adapt technology, you're going to be left behind. I think the same thing happened, you know, when they, in the early 1950s or 60s, you know, when there were these horse-drawn carriages and suddenly these vehicles came in. A couple of years, it completely vanished. And in India, it happened, you know, that there's this interesting gentleman who gave this example of coolies. You know, at one point in time, all the train station, you know, there were coolies. And you know, what made them redundant was a simple innovation by VIP, trolley bags, wheels.
Yeah.
You know, but just simple innovation, not even something which is like really. But right now, I think we are in a point of time where technology is growing exponentially. And it's not just AR, VR, MR. It's all of these technologies like 5G, artificial intelligence. It's converging and it's growing at a rapid pace. You know, I mean, and you know, what you buy today, maybe like a phone, you realize that in another 6 months it's becoming done because there's something which is 10 times better. So we are getting to a very interesting space. Now, tell me, with your content that you are building, are you looking at partnering with hardware, you know, devices and stuff like that?
I would say that, you know, yes, we are always open to innovative partnerships. And one of the key things is that whenever we get a chance, we try to explore, we try to test the boundaries of various different people who are providing and developing technologies. It's always 1 + 1 = 11, you know, when we always talk about, okay, so partnerships are very, very important. I would say aspect of any particular ecosystem to develop as a holistic development. So it is very, very important. We are always open for partnerships.
Recently, Jio has been going to cities looking for developers and content creators because they said they'll be launching their headset in a couple of months. So what comes next after Chandrayaan VR? What's the bank of content? What's the plan ahead?
Next we are doing is the human body, going inside human body. We are taking kids into human body to explain them the respiratory system and the digestive system. Then we are focused on electricity. There's a Jurassic era, there's a dwarf energy, earth ecology. There are many titles which is coming and which supports the current education plus topics which are different, which are not taught in the school, but are very much important for children. You know, there's life in the water, wildlife, electricity, robotics, Indian Army. We want to introduce kids how our soldiers, where they live, how they operate their vehicles, what they do in robotics, how AI is going to change the future. You know, in the industrialized, how it's going to change it. earth ecology, climate, here, how our climate is changing. So kids at a very young age, they need to learn all these topics. They need to understand these difficult topics in an immersive way where they can really see what's happening around them. We cannot, you know, show kids the impact of Amazon forest and how it has destroyed the forest and the wildlife. But if we immersively we take kids right there in the forest fires, they can really see the impact of the disaster it has been carried out. Plus, very important, Jurassic era in India. I don't know how many Indians know what all dinosaurs were found in India. Not all of them come from the Hollywood, but we also have dinosaurs. So we want to teach or take kids to show them exactly these are the Indian dinosaur species were found in India, so that they know, you know, what are the names of all these dinosaurs. So this is all content is global, plus with the Indian touch to it.
Lovely, and I can see there's an interesting list of titles that you guys are working on. Yes. Would you guys like to talk a little bit about the upcoming titles?
Yes, we can give a small prelude, okay, about our next title, which is coming on, which we are releasing in April. It's primarily more about, you know, we go inside a human body and then we try to explore how our body system works, you know, when it taken into context of learning and knowledge to children, what is the impact of different type of food, the air that we breathe, how our digestions and everything works. So it's going to be a very exciting title. We are anyways, getting quite excited about it, you know, the sooner, you know, it is coming closer to it. But yes, this is the next title that is going to be up. And again, action-packed role play for kids to again, you know, explore something which was never possible. Kids must have seen movies and videos, you know, how things function, but they would have never gone inside particular organ and seen, you know, how things are working over there. So the whole imagination just changes over there.
So Rishi and Aditya, would you like to paint a picture of what the future of education is going to look like in this decade?
See, I would like my kid to actually showcase his vision or his dream in a format where he can present what his thinking. Maybe he's not very good at drawing, but if he puts a VR and he creates something and showcases me, that's what I like to see the future in education, where they can, like I say, dream without any boundaries, you know, where I'm sure that very soon people can start creating their own stuff. In VR, like I know people are doing painting now in VR, there's a virtual art gallery in VR. So everything is possible in VR. So I would like one kid see something, he comes back to home from school, he puts in VR and start putting his dreams together block by block, you know, like Lego, he start building up, maybe in a very crude way, but it will keep on shaping up. So that's why I say imagination is the key. Let kid imagine, let be fearless, and let them break the boundaries of restrictions.
Absolutely. That's what I think. Right. Okay. Lovely. Rishi.
Okay. For me, I go step by step. Okay. For me, the first most important thing is that VR is made accessible to everybody, every corner, every single place. Okay. The key is that imagination, as we've been talking so many times, okay, the vision, the knowledge. But yes, the accessibility is point number one, that VR is utilized everywhere. That's part number one. Part number two is in terms of when we talk about what in VR is to have the highest quality content, not just any content. You know, as Indians, we are a price sensitive market. You know, we always look at that. But, you know, we always want the cheapest, you know, product with us, you know, so long as, you know, it is solving our problem, it's a good thing. Even for the namesake, okay? But that's not the vision. The vision is that how do I make our kids dream about that they are the next scientists, they are the next nano engineers, they are the one who are designing the AI and not using the AI as a tool. we don't see, our country, to be an exporter of the knowledge, but actually creator of the knowledge. That is what is the most important thing for me. And I believe that VR is just a spark. We are just sitting at the tip of an iceberg right now. Then we can actually imagine the potential of this technology and how it can change and bring wonders to the generation, not just in India, but globally, in fact. Okay. Yeah. So that is what I see to paint, picture with VR and Clip VR as a technology.
Lovely, lovely. Thank you, Rishi. Thank you, Adi, for joining in and sharing your insights. I see your passion coming through, and you guys have given some profound insights on how the education industry is going to look like in the near future. And I double your passion and your vision, because I think we are getting into the future of abundance. We are getting into the limitless possibilities, unlimitless, and virtual reality as a technology can, if you are curious and if you are a desire to learn more and if you are a builder, you will be able to innovate and build anything. And this tool in the hand of the education industry and of future generation will, like Rishi, you mentioned, will create a India which is brave, which is not exporting our minds out, but creating those, not just companies, but products and solutions and companies which will not just transform India, but transform the rest of the world. So I am excited for that world, and I believe that is possible. And I believe that virtual reality as a tool can do that. And education, I think, is just about opening up and waking up from the deep slumber and understanding the potential that these technology has. And I hope and I wish that everybody comes in and starts adopting and adapting. And I'm sure in due course time, the accessibility problem will also be sorted, where the price points will be more consumer friendly. Wish you the very best. I'm going to leave behind your contacts behind so they can reach out to you. And to my listeners, if you like what you see in here, please put the subscribe button until next time. See you once more. Thank you. Thank you.
Right.